how can you eat glass without getting hurt? And the students are, you know, they will think through this and they will say things like, well, what if the glass is like really smooth? Or maybe you are eating very small marbles. And they are thinking just about the glass that they know. But of course, hard candy is a glass. And so we talk about this, these physical properties. And to a physicist or a chemist, hard candy is a glass. And it's a glass like silica glass that we might have in our windshields or our eyeglasses, but it is a glass. And so we're able to talk about why we actually produce glasses in the food industry for the purpose of eating, and why glass is the right structure for certain foods versus others. And so just leading questions like that, where the students really don't know what to expect, and it kind of leads them off one direction, and then we kind of pull them back into the reality of the science. And I think that might be even more surprising to them than the idea of, say, eating very, very small marbles. So it kind of gets their attention when we ask those sort of questions.